Good morning, students. Now today I am going to teach you kinds of noun. You have read what is noun? Noun are naming words. Naming words means these are names of any person, any place, anything or animal are called noun. So today we will study kinds of noun. Kinds of noun, you have done one exercise of noun. Kinds of noun, you have done proper noun and common noun. So proper noun, what is proper noun? Name of a particular person, place, animal or thing. When we talk about any particular person, particular place, particular thing, it is called proper noun. Let's say, let's take example, your name, okay, it's proper noun. My name, proper noun. Take name of any city. You are living in, suppose, Behror, proper noun. Jaipur, proper noun. Delhi, proper noun. Then, okay, name of animals. So, animal, if you talk about your pet dog, my pet dog Bruno, proper noun, okay. So, when we talk about particular person, place, animal or thing, it is proper noun. Next is common noun. Common noun, when we talk about a person in general, जब हम जनरली किसी की बात करते हैं, लाइक प्लेस, एनिमल और थिंग, पर्सन, प्लेस और थिंग. पर्सन, सपोज आई से बॉयज, सो इट कैन बी एनी बॉयज. बॉयज इज अ कॉमन नाउन. इफ आई से आई एम गोइंग टू द सिटी, कैन बी एनी सिटी, सो सिटी इज कॉमन नाउन. नाउ देयर आर सो मेनी एनिमल्स इन द जंगल, एनिमल, इट कैन बी एनी एनिमल, सो इट इज ऑल्सो अ कॉमन नाउन. नाउ थिंग, इट कैन बी एनी थिंग, लाइक आई love eating biscuits. Now we have not specified about any particular biscuit, so it is a that common noun. Next, children, collective noun. Collective noun, when we talk about collection of people, collection of animals or collection of things, means when we talk about group of people, group of animals or group of things. So you have read, let's take example, okay, swarm of bees. So swarm, it is collective noun. Crowd of people, crowd, it is collective noun, means many people are gathered at a place, so we give it a name, crowd. Bouquet of flowers, when so many flowers are arranged in a vase or anywhere they are kept together, so we say bouquet of flowers. Okay, so there are so many collective nouns given in your book also, you have already revised them. Then next is abstract noun. Noun that cannot be seen, that cannot be touched, but only can be felt or experienced. Noun जिसको हम देख नहीं सकते, जिसको हम छू नहीं सकते, क्या कर सकते हैं? We can only feel it. हम उसको केवल feel कर सकते हैं. So that also comes in category of noun and it is abstract noun. So what kind of noun those are, like joy, happiness, isn't it? Anger, देख सकते हो? नहीं देख सकते. Bravery, बहादुरी, can you see, can you touch? No. So it is also abstract noun, the noun which you cannot see, which you cannot touch, which you can only feel. So now let's do the exercise of our book. Open, children, page number, you have done one exercise, okay, which is given on page number 24. You have done one exercise. Now we are going to do exercise A, which is given on page number 24. So open your book, page number 24. I am going to rub it, children. We are next going to do exercise given on page number 24. This is your Pearson book, Tune Into Grammar, page number 24, exercise A. We are going to do filling the blanks with proper noun. You have to fill the blank with the proper noun. Dash was a freedom fighter. Now you can write any one name here. Suppose I am writing Subhash Chandra Bose. Subhash Chandra Bose. You can write name of any freedom fighter. So Subhash Chandra Bose was a freedom fighter. first word of this sentence? So holy. If proper noun comes in between the sentence, then also it will begin with capital letter only. Proper noun अगर sentence के बीच में भी आता है तो भी वो capital से ही लिखा जाता है. Now third one, dash is the capital of France. What is the capital of France? Paris. So P-A-R-I-S, Paris is the capital of France. Next, dash is my favorite actor. Any actor's name you can write. Suppose I am write Akshay. Okay, so Akshay Kumar. You can write your favorite actor's name, any of the actor which you like most. Next, dash, watching dash made me cry. Watching TV. Fifth one, watching TV or watching television made me cry. Next, dash is my favorite hill station. You can write any name of the hill station. Now here I am writing Shimla. Shimla is my favorite hill station. Next, dash is famous for its temples. So many cities in India are famous for temples, but when you will Google it, you will get the name of Bhubaneswar, which is the city of temples, famous for city of temples in India. So I am writing its name. It's called as Bhubaneswar, but it is written as Bhubaneswar. Okay, so Bhubaneswar is right. Next, dash is the separate book of Christians. So Christians, they worship Lord Jesus, and Bible is their sacred book. So Bible. Next, children, my birthday falls in the month of. So in which month your birthday falls, that you will write on your own. Okay. Now, tenth one, I can speak. Which two languages you can speak? I think everyone can speak well Hindi and English. So you can write your mother tongue also if you wish. Okay. So now languages are written with capital letter and it is proper noun Hindi and English. Okay. So write it down. This we have done exercise A of page number 24. This is exercise given on page number 24. Okay, children. Now next we are going to do exercise B, which is given on page number 25. So I am going to rub it. You can pause your video here and you can complete your work. So I am going to rub, children. Next exercise we will do, which is given on page number 25. Okay, page number 25. Now B exercise, fill in the blanks with the correct collective nouns. Okay, so you have to fill in the blanks with the collective noun. In previous exercise you have filled proper noun. Now here you have to fill collective noun. First one, Rohan was attacked by a dash of bees. So collective noun for bees is swarm of bees. S-W-A-R-M, swarm of bees. Next, a dash of thieves robbed the bank. So collective noun for thieves, it is gang. A gang of thieves robbed the bank. Next, a dash of sailors. So collective noun for sailors is crew. A dash of sailors, crew of sailors. Next, a dash of singers sang the welcome song. So group of singers, we give collective noun. So it is choir, choir of singers. Next, do not touch that dash of papers. Dash of paper, sheaf of papers. S-H-E-A-F, sheaf of papers. Do not touch that sheaf of papers. Next is, children, number 5 we have done. 6 is a dash of horses gallop across the fields. So group of horses is called a team of horses. A team of horses. There are three other collective nouns also which are used for group of horses. One is stud, one is rug, and one is harness. But in your book it is given team of horses. Okay. Next, a dash of wolves. A pack of wolves. So collective noun for wolves is a pack of wolves. Next, the dash of buffaloes had blocked the traffic. So the dash of buffaloes. What is the group of buffaloes called? The herd of buffaloes. The herd of buffaloes blocked the traffic. Next, my father used a dash of tools. Dash of tools, set of tools. My father used a set of tools. A dash of monkeys. Collective noun used for monkeys is troop. A troop of monkeys ate all the bananas from the tree. So collective noun for monkeys we will use troop. A troop of monkeys. Okay, children, so write it down in your book. Fill all these exercises. Now come to next page, page number 26. Now there is one box also, and some abstract nouns are given. Abstract noun of quality, of action and events, of state, of feelings, of ideas and concepts. So you have to learn all these abstract nouns given on page number 26. Now children, next, you can also, abstract noun can be also formed with the help of adjectives. So here I am writing adjective, okay, and I am giving you some examples of abstract noun which is formed with the help of those adjectives. Abstract noun. Okay, so now adjective brave. He is a brave boy. Brave is the adjective. Now we can form abstract noun with the help of brave, bravery. He was awarded for his bravery. So here bravery is abstract noun. Long. Long. Abstract noun formed with the help of long is length. L-E-N-G-T-H. Length. L-E-N-G-T-H. This you don't have to write. This is only to make you understand. Okay. Now, invite. बेटा ये आपको लिखना नहीं है, ये केवल समझाने के लिए है. So, which abstract noun will be formed? Invitation. Okay. So, these examples are given. Okay. So, you can make abstract nouns, you can form abstract nouns from adjectives also. Now children, I am going to rub this, okay, and we are going to do next exercise. So do it children, in your book write with pencil only, don't use pen for writing in book, and do your work in neat and clean handwriting. Okay children. So, next is few more examples are given, like marry, abstract noun is marriage, okay, child, childhood, companion, companionship. Now here your next exercise which is given on page number 26. Next exercise given on page number 26. So it is, underline the abstract nouns and encircle the noun that you can see and touch in these sentences. In sentence pe kya karna hai aapko, abstract noun ke niche line khichni hai, and you have to encircle, you have to circle the noun which you can see, which you can touch. Okay, so now first sentence I am reading. This ointment helps relieve muscle pain. So here what is the noun which you can see? So, ointment, you can see the noun which you can see, okay, so you have to circle, सेंट को हम देख सकते हैं, साधु को हम देख सकते हैं. सो सर्कल इट, दिस इज द नाउन यू कैन सी. एंड वॉज रिस्पेक्टेड फॉर इज विजडम, विजडम यू कैनॉट सी, विजडम कैन बी ओनली फेल्ट. बुद्धिमानी को हम केवल महसूस कर सकते हैं. हाउ मच वाइज ही इज, ओके. सो वाइज से क्या बन गया, विजडम. नेक्स्ट चिल्ड्रन, द सोल्जर वॉज रिवॉर्डेड फॉर हिज ब्रेवरी. सोल्जर, दिस इज सोल्जर, यू कैन सी सोल्जर को आप देख सकते हैं. सो सर्कल इट. एंड ब्रेवरी यू कैनॉट सी, बहादुरी किसी की नहीं देख सकते, यू कैन ओनली फील ब्रेवरी. सो अंडरलाइन इट. नेक्स्ट इज फोर्थ नंबर, एलिस एंड जॉन शेयर अ ट्रू फ्रेंडशिप. सो एलिस एंड जॉन, दे आर नेम्स, ऑफकोर्स यू कैन सी दीज टू पीपल व्हेन दे कम इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू. सो एलिस एंड जॉन, सो सर्कल देम. एंड एलिस एंड जॉन शेयर अ ट्रू फ्रेंडशिप. किसी की फ्रेंडशिप को यू कैन नॉट सी, यू कैन ओनली फील इट. सो फ्रेंडशिप, ओके, अंडरलाइन फ्रेंडशिप. नेक्स्ट चिल्ड्रन, फिफ्थ वन, ईटिंग जंक फूड इज नॉट गुड फॉर हेल्थ. सो जंक फूड यू कैन सी, जंक फूड यू कैन सी. सो जंक फूड यू सर्कल इट. एंड वॉट यू कैन नॉट सी, हेल्थ इज नॉट गुड फॉर हेल्थ. हेल्थ यू कैन नॉट सी, यू कैन ओनली फील. ओके, सो दिस इज एब्स्ट्रैक्ट नाउन, अंडरलाइन. नेक्स्ट सिक्स पॉइंट, माई ड्रीम इज टू बिकम अ डांसर. सो ड्रीम, ड्रीम यू कैन नॉट सी. सो ड्रीम इट इज एब्स्ट्रैक्ट नाउन, ड्रीम अंडरलाइन. एंड डांसर यू कैन सी अ डांसर, सो डांसर इज अ कॉमन नाउन. ओके, नेक्स्ट चिल्ड्रन, सेवेंथ पॉइंट, फॉक्सेस आर नोन फॉर देयर क्लेवरनेस. सो फॉक्सेस यू कैन सी, फॉक्सेस, ओके. सो फॉक्सेस यू, वॉट यू विल डू, फॉक्सेस यू विल सर्कल देम. एंड नोन फॉर देयर क्लेवरनेस, सो क्लेवरनेस यू कैन नॉट सी. सो क्लेवरनेस what you will do, underline, it is abstract noun. Okay, so I'm going to rub first two. Children, you can pause and you can do this exercise in your book. Okay, so next I'm going to rub these three, okay, four I'm rubbing. Okay, so next, eighth point, the duck swam across the entire length of the lake. So duck you can see, so duck is here the noun which you can see. So circle it. And length of the lake, length, length is abstract noun made from long. So it is abstract noun, draw a line under it, underline. Nine, during my childhood I played a lot of outdoor games. So their childhood, childhood is abstract noun, childhood. So draw a line under it. And games, games is noun. Okay, so abstract noun is childhood, and games it is common noun. Next, the boy was rewarded for his excellent behavior. So boy here is common noun. And excellent behavior, excellent it is abstract noun. So underline excellent and circle boy. Okay, so this is the exercise given on page number 27. So all these exercises which we have done today, children, you will complete all these exercises in your book itself. Okay, that's all for today. Have a good day. Thank you.